Hi friends, this is Dr. Apoor Mehra, and I represent Conceptual Orthopedics here. And for every teacher or every student or as a doctor, it is a great thing that if your fellow countryman elevates and gets a degree behind his name, it is never easy. It is not supposed to be easy. If it was easy, everybody will do it. But then there are some people who really work hard and make sure that for next generations, everything in their family changes. With me is one such young man, one such young orthopedic surgeon called as Dr. Siddharth Ray. Siddharth, before we go on to what you have done, tell me why you became a doctor.
First of all, good evening, sir. Thank you for the warm introduction. Sir, as far as I can remember, sir, I was since class 5 or class 6, sir, doctors are someone who always inspired me. I always looked upon this profession, sir, mostly because they had this tremendous power of healing. And also, sir, they were regarded as the second gods. So that is my earliest memories when it goes to, you know, when I think of everything, you know. So from the very beginning, I had one thing in my mind, like I have to be a doctor. I never considered being an engineer. So that is where my focus was. And sir, it was mostly because, sir, I liked what they do. I liked the profession. I liked how doctors could help people. I liked how they were such an important, you know, part of the society and how they could, they are the bone of health and infrastructure, sir. Let's be very sure about it. And so I just wanted to make a contribution, sir. It didn't matter whether it would be a small contribution or big one, but I just wanted to be a part of it, sir. I never aspired to be anyone else. I always wanted to be a doctor. And sir, my parents backed me. My teachers backed me, sir, in school, and hence the journey, sir. So I guess, sir, after 10 years later, sir, I'm sitting as a doctor. I got a degree of doctor, sir, 5 years back, 4 years back rather. So I'm really happy about it.
Fantastic. Then you went on to do orthopedics. Why orthopedics?
Mostly internship, sir. When I was interning, sir, our internship regimen, sir, I graduated from Jorhat Medical College, but my hometown, I'm from Guwahati. I belong to Guwahati, sir. So I did my internship from Guwahati. The internship is very rigorous here, sir. Every posting you have to do very sincerely. So when I was working department per department, I think orthopedics is the subject where I inclined to the most. Because sir, medicine mein, sir, I liked medicine theoretically, but I knew ki practically I wouldn't be able to do as much. Sending investigation, that was not what I was meant to do. Internship, I got a chance to reduce scoliosis fracture. I got a chance to see my seniors, sir, the first year PGTs at that time, doing closed dissection of hips. I was also lucky enough to assist in many cases. And sir, from then on, sir, I had just one thing in my mind. I had to crack my PG exams and take orthopedics in GMC itself. So I wanted to do it from my hometown. So, bas wahi aim tha, sir. And that was the only thing that I wanted to do. It's more because of what we do. I like the subject. I like everything that is there about orthopedics, sir. Or one more reason, sir, medicine internship, I didn't like it that much there also.
Right. So you got inclined towards orthopedics. You joined your dream place. You were exactly, really in love with the branch, I think. You would
Yes, sir, since internship.
Fantastic. So you would have enjoyed those 3 years?
Exactly, sir. First year, sir, it was very hectic. Didn't know, sir, I was not oriented most of the times. The duties were very hectic as a first year resident. You have to manage in Guwahati Medical College, sir. You have to manage the OPD emergency, and then you have to prepare the patients for emergency OT, then major OT again. So I think I hardly slept 2 or 3 days per week. Not even 2 or 3 days, sir. Hardly 1 or 2 days a week, sir, proper sleep, 5 to 6 hours. Other than that, I was mostly in duties. So us waqt, sir, I did question myself. But I always try to see things in the bigger perspective. I always knew that this subject is very rewarding. So I wanted to see my life 5 to 6 years beyond. I dreamt of that. And sir, and that is what pushed me through the first year of residency. And once the first year residency got over, sir, it was just as what I had expected. So I got time to assist in cases, do a few cases in emergency OT myself. And it was all that love affair that started from second year of residency. So yes, sir, I'd say first year was really, really hectic. And second and third year were just dream for me, sir.
Fantastic. And I believe when you were in third year, That was the time conceptual orthopedics would have joined you, or you would
have exactly, sir. Yes, sir. I got to know about conceptual orthopedics through a YouTube video, sir. And since that was a corona pandemic was going on, the academics in our college, sir, like all other colleges in India, got a little affected. So I thought it's a perfect time to, you know, kind of learn something extra from the professors and just gain the advantage, sir. So I joined conceptual orthopedics because our seminars had closed down by then because of the pandemic. It was the first wave in our country and we were all given corona details. That was towards the transit time. So when I was transiting from second year to third year, my seniors were about to give their exams. And that is the point where I joined conceptual orthopedics. And the journey has been awesome since then with conceptual orthopedics.
What areas of the conceptual orthopedics app have you utilized? For example, there are videos, there are notes, there are live sessions, there are special courses. So what is the area that you really loved?
Sir, to be really honest, sir, I liked everything about conceptual orthopedics. But since because of the duty constraint and because of the hours, I was not able to utilize the app 100%, sir. And I don't think you can utilize the app 100% in 1 year. It's just too much knowledge in here, sir. Even if you utilize 10% of it, and I can say it on record, sir, if you utilize 10% of it and you do it honestly, I think you'll be very, very far ahead from your competitors or people who are, you know, in the same boat as you. So, sir, how it started was I started watching videos of case presentation because that is a very important part of our exams. So long cases, sir, I'd watch videos of hip and spine mainly. So hip video, I remember you were doing one video, and spine case, sir, I remember I watched the entire examination. I read it through. I made a format for myself. And firstly, sir, when I finished this hip and spine, because I knew long cases, either hip or spine would be there. So I prepared for long case format. And then secondly, sir, I finished the videos on traumatology by Shailesh Pai, sir. It was very informative, sir. All those factors which are important, it was very beautifully elucidated by sir. It was very nicely given, sir. And I think once you attend those videos and you make a note out of those videos, you don't need to do any extra. And one more feature of conceptual orthopedics, which I absolutely loved, sir, was the notes on recent advances. Unfortunately, sir, we have in MS exams, we get 4 papers. You have books and you have materials from where you can study those about those 3 papers. But the 4th paper, sir, there's no such source available in market from where you can prepare for the 4th paper. So I completely relied on conceptual orthopedics as far as my preparation for the 4th paper was concerned. And I think, sir, thanks to the app, I was able to attempt all the questions very nicely, 10 questions. More or less, I was very satisfied with my answer and I completely relied on conceptual orthopedics for that 4th paper. And all the other 3 papers, sir, I just used conceptual orthopedics notes to augment my preparation, sir. So I'd read books and I'd make notes for myself and I'd see the conceptual, the pattern in which the notes are given, sir. They are very friendly. It's very easy to memorize. So I just add on some notes, delete some part of that. So that is how it started, sir. So I use the notes and I use the case presentation videos and the trauma videos mostly that I was able to utilize, sir. So because of the time constraint, I was not able to join so much of the live sessions, but few of the sessions I did, I managed to attend, sir. Like I remember attending one session on compartment syndrome by, I think, Shetty, sir. It was very informative, sir. And also, sir, I have to mention Dimri, sir. I remember he had video presentation on osteoporosis, sir, where he had mentioned all about those drug trials, holiday drug trials, which you never find in any book. And that helped me in preparing my seminar also, sir. I got very good remarks from my professors because I used all those knowledge in my slides, which is nowhere mentioned in any textbooks. So yes, sir, it was really a very nice. And that incidentally was very nice, sir. It helped me all throughout, sir, in my seminars, in my exams. So I'm very thankful to the app.
Fantastic. And Siddharth,
yes, sir.
What comes to your mind? I'll speak some words. Just describe what and how you will remember them. Professor, how will you remember him?
Sir Legend. Sir Legend.
That's the word for him. What is the word for Professor S.M. Tuli?
Sir, I think there's a sport acronym, sir, which reads GOAT. That is the greatest of all times. So I think I'd like to use that acronym on S.M. Tuli, sir. He's undoubtedly the greatest orthopedician of all time. So that O fits in for him also, sir.
Right. And
the GOAT, I guess.
Fantastic. What about Professor Shantaram Shetty, sir? A word that comes to your mind.
Sir, informative. Sir, everything he says is very informative, sir. It's to the point, it's crisp, and he just speaks to the point, sir. That is the thing I like about him, sir.
Precise and exact.
Exactly,
sir. Shailesh Pai.
Sir, trauma master.
The master of trauma.
Master of trauma.
Professor Sudhir Kumar.
Sir, he's a father figure, sir. Sudhir Kumar, sir, he has those mustaches, sir, which reminds me of my grandfather, sir. I'm sorry to say that, but that's the thing, sir. I have tremendous respect for him. Whenever I see his pit or whenever I'm attending his session, I just bow down, sir. I mean, it's tremendous respect that I have for him, sir. He's absolutely a father figure, sir.
Dr. Professor V.B. Basim.
Sir, great mentor.
And I'm just including the very senior people. Professor Gopa Kumar.
Okay, sir. So he's awesome. I guess I'll use the word awesome for him.
Right. And obviously, you spoke about Dr. Ravinder Dimri. But if you have to summarize the man in one word, it's difficult. You can use a sentence for him. What will you love to use for him?
So he is who I aspire to be. I think the way he presents his lecture, the way he forms around it, I think I'll request everyone who has joined this app just to go and watch two videos of Ravinder Dimri, sir. So one would be osteoporosis and one would be his talk on metallurgy. I think if you attend those videos, so you'll know what the man is all about, sir. I think he has summed up metallurgy in the most lucid and the most easiest ways of possible in 110 minutes, I guess, and osteoporosis somewhere in 50 to 60 minutes. I think if you just attend those lectures, make a note out of it, you don't have to do anything for metallurgy, which is a very tough subject, sir, because basic science in most of the colleges is neglected. And osteoporosis, I think you'll know. It's just a treat to hear him, sir. The way he formulates his lectures, sir, from start to the finish, you just feel, I wish I could do it sometimes, you know, sir. It's impossible to copy him. It's impossible to emulate him, sir, whatever he does. It's just, I would say it's just pure magic, sir. He knows how to use words. He knows how to use time. And he just does it in a perfect way, sir, every single time.
Wonderful. I knew that you won't be able to give a word to him. So I gave you more.
Exactly. For him.
I could see in your eyes. Dr. Harpreet Singh.
Sir, he's tremendous, sir. His videos are just amazing. I have attended all his videos and I did learn a lot from it, sir.
Fantastic. Finally, after seeing so many things, what is your interest now? Did the German teacher, Professor Heiko Greitchen, impress you?
Yes, sir. He did interest me, sir. I did find it fascinating. I attended his lectures. And it was nice, sir. I'd say it was very enriching, sir. Overall, the experience was very enriching. And the same goes for Professor Heiko Greitchen, sir.
What do you want to become? Means what branch you want to go into, sir, specialize into?
Sir, I'm more inclined towards sports medicine, sir. I'm interested in sports. And I wish I can, you know, do something in that field, sir.
Phenomenal. And have you decided, narrowed down the area? Shoulder, knee or ankle?
Sir, shoulder most probably, I'd say.
That's why you like Harpreet. And last, I'll tell you one thing. You must be, sir, around 29 years, 28 years?
Sir, I'm 27. I'll be turning 28 on August 17th. Next one, sir.
Right. Advance happy birthday. But I'll just tell you one thing. You have a great idea of understanding people. Orthopedics will take you ahead. But your way of understanding people and describing human beings will take you far ahead, very, very long.
Please, thank you so much, sir.
Express my best wishes to your family, specifically for your parents. I can see they have reared you very well. And
they are very happy, sir. Last Saturday, sir, I was doing my OPD, sir. As a senior resident, I have joined in Guwahati Medical College. So the first thing I did was I called my mom and I told her that Apoor Mehra sir had called, and she was like, are you sure it was Apoor Mehra? I was like, yes, my mom, he had called and he has asked me to join an interview, and she was really happy, sir. And so one more thing, sir, you've asked me to describe everyone, but you didn't ask for yourself, sir. So if there's one word that I'd like to use it for you, sir, that would be a guru, sir. I've watched your videos on YouTube, sir. They are really very inspiring, sir. I do watch them, sir, when I'm feeling low, and I just like to request you, sir, from as a fellow orthopedician or a fellow student of yours, sir, please keep making those videos. You never know how many lives you have touched, sir. So whenever whenever I felt low, sir, throughout my preparation, sir, and even in my PG preparation, sir, when I was doing postgraduate preparation, I did watch those videos, sir, and it was really inspiring, sir. So I'd like to request you to continue making those videos on YouTube, sir.
So you use the word guru for me.
Exactly, so, sir.
As an extension of the Guru Dakshina, you yes, should sir. Contribute and do what I have been doing. मजा तो तब है जब एक्सपोनेंशियली लोग ये काम करें
exactly,
मैं छूं कुछ को तुम छुओ हम सब मिलके सब कुछ हुए
जी सर
तो अगर कुछ करना है बेटा सो स्प्रेड पॉजिटिविटी
श्योर सर
इन दिस वर्ल्ड पीपल नीड अ पैट ऑन अ बैक एंड दे नीड दीज वर्ड्स ऑफ एनकरेजमेंट ऑल इज वेल सब ठीक हो जाएगा And as you
exactly,
look at clinician, patients will look in your eyes, where you have to assure in your eyes, even before you speak, that I am the captain of the ship, and I will sail you through. Best wishes, young man. I am waiting
so
for
much,
your
sir.
First video, which you will record and send. And I promise, I will put in the motivational section. On conceptual orthopedics as a tribute to your parents, the way they have raised you and taken care of you. Enjoy Siddharth, enjoy the brand.
Thank you so much, sir.
Stay in touch, keep contributing. Bye.
Sure, sir.